Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this powerful image of Jupiter with its turbulent surface and one of its dramatic moons. I provided this cracked soil texture that you could use to create the moon. If you'd like to use it, its link is located in my video's description or project files below. Create a new document by going to File and New. Make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then, click Create or OK. Open your gradient tool and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Open your gradient thumbnails and click the gear icon to open your list of gradient presets. Click Noise Samples and click OK to replace your current gradients with the noise sample gradients. I'll click this gradient, but feel free to pick another. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Check Restrict Colors, which prevents oversaturated colors. The color mode is HSB, which represents hue, saturation, and brightness. I'll drag the left hue slider to the right until I like the hues in the gradient bar. I'll drag the right saturation slider to the left to decrease the overall color saturation. If you want to see other gradients that conform to your above settings, click Randomize. Then, click OK. Go to the top of your document and press and hold Shift as you drag your gradient tool to the bottom. Then, release. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify the filters that we'll be adding to it at any time. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Distort, and Ripple. I'll make the amount 30% and the size large. However, feel free to use other settings. You can always change it later if you want. Next, we'll warp the overall shape of our image. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. When you see this message, click OK. It's just telling us that the filters will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Let's zoom out of our document to have more room to manipulate the transform. Press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a few times. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. As before, click OK. Go to the top left corner and drag the transform straight up approximately this much. Click the Warp Mode icon and drag the same control points as I'm doing here to create a bowed effect. Make sure you drag the bottom control points approximately the same distance as the top control points. Then, click the check mark at the top. Next, we'll place the right side of our planet into deep shadow. Click the new layer icon and change its blend mode to multiply. Open your gradients and click the gear icon. Click Reset Gradients and click OK. Click the black-white gradient and place your cursor approximately here. Press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient line to approximately here. Open your Transform tool and, as before, click the Warp Mode icon. To create a slight arc in the shadow, drag the same control points the same distance as mine. Then, click the check mark at the top. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll add the moon. Open the texture I provided, or if you prefer another texture, open it. Open your elliptical marquee tool, go to a corner, and press and hold Shift as you drag a selection to the opposite corner. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the circular shape from the image. Go to Filter, Distort, and Spherize. Make the amount 100% and click OK. To spherize it more, press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the last filter and press it twice. To place it into our Jupyter document, press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the Jupyter document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool and go to a corner. When you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the Transform and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll place the right side of the moon in deep shadow. Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail of the moon to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the moon. Then, click the moon to make it active. Open your Brush tool. Make the size approximately 150 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow both 100%. Brush over the right side of the moon in a slight arc. Next, we'll brighten the left side of our planet. Double-click the Smart Object to open its source image. Zoom out of your document to give us more room. Open your Dodge tool. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Now, white is your foreground color. Make the range midtones, the exposure 100%, and the tool size 1800 pixels. Place your cursor approximately here and click once. Move your cursor to the left a little and click again. Close the tab of the Smart Object. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Go to Filter and Liquify. There are 12 Liquify tools which I covered in many of my tutorials. For this example, we'll use the Twirl Clockwise tool almost exclusively. I'll make the size 60, the density 50, and the pressure and rate 100. Drag your tool across in a straight line, and every second or so, slow your rate of speed a little, which creates a subtle twirl effect. Repeat this across your entire image. If you don't like a particular twirl that you've made, click the Reconstruct tool and brush over it to restore that area of the original image. Then, click OK. Close the tab of the Smart Object and click Yes to save the changes. Next, I'll show you how to quickly change the colors. With your Smart Object still active, click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Drag the Hue slider to the right and left. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.